Next is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 2nd Chapter, text number 30, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 9th, 1972, in Vrindavan, India.
Sāyī vīdaṁ sasajyāgri bhagavānātumāya सदसत रूपया चासु गुणो मैया अगुणो विभो सो हियर इज द इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ क्रिएशन द क्रिएशन इज फ्रॉम ए पर्सन नॉट फ्रॉम द इम्पर्सनल फीचर ऑफ द एब्सोल्यूट सोर्स क्रिएशन There must be brain, otherwise how there is question of creation? We are part and parcel of Krishna. We have also creative power. So, as soon as there is question of creative power, there must be a brain behind the creation, and brain means a person. Creation cannot be possible from void or impersonal thing. We have several times discussed this point that the government, this word, appears to be impersonal. But actually, behind the government, there is a person. The president or the king, like that. So, this creation, cosmic manifestation, is possible through the creative power of the Supreme Person. Therefore, God cannot be impersonal. Impersonal feature is one of the manifestation of God. God must be a person. This is the conclusion. Sa eva idam, this cosmic manifestation was created. In another place it is said, aham eva asam agre. Before creation, there was God, Krishna. And when this material creation will be finished, He will remain. Therefore, Krishna or God is not one of these created, material created things. That is admitted even by the staunchest impersonalist, Shankaracharya, Narayana Parah Abhaktyad, Bhakta Abhakta, this Mahatattva, from which this material cosmic manifestation is there, but Narayana Parah, Narayana is above, that means above this creation. Narayana or Krishna is not one of the product of this creation. Just like our existence, we are one of the products of this creation. The Narayana or Krishna is not one of the products of this material creation. Therefore, it is to be understood that Krishna's body is not material. But the Mayavadi philosophers, they think like that Krishna is God, but He has accepted a material body. This is Mayavadi philosophy. But how Krishna can accept a material body? Because He existed before the material creation. Another consideration is that even if we accept a material body, that is not material for him. That is also spiritual. It appears to us as material, but that is spiritual. Parasa Shakti Vividha Iva Sriyate, he has got multi energies, and because he is spirit, complete spirit, therefore his energies are also spiritual. Shakti Shakti Mato Abheda. There cannot be any distinction between the powerful and the power. So here it is clearly said that Saivedam Sasujyagi Bhagavan Atmamayana. Bhagavan created by his energy. It is not that Bhagavan is finished after this creation. The Mahabharata philosophy is that everything is God, therefore there is no separate existence of God. That is impersonally. But here it is said that Bhagavan Atma Mayaya, he created this cosmic manifestation by his energy. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avasishyat. His full energy, even if it is taken away from him, is still he is full, he is complete. He is not exhausted. Saivedam Sasajyagri Bhagavan Asumayam Sadasat Rupaya. The Maya is displayed, Maya means energy, that is displayed in two ways, material and spiritual. Material is asat and spiritual is sat. Asat means which does not exist permanently. Bhutta bhutta praliyata. It is created, again it is annihilated. Therefore, it is called sometimes asat. Asat means not false, but not permanent. So, this material creation is also manifestation of Krishna's energy, and there is another creation that is not creation, that is always existing, that is the spiritual world, sanatana. Parastasmat tu bhava anya bhaktat bhaktat sanatana. That manifestation, that is internal potential. This is external potency. This material world is manifestation of the external potency of Krishna, whereas the spiritual world is the manifestation of his internal potency. Unfortunately, the modern advancement of education has no information what is that spiritual world. Yes, they have no information. They are concerned with this material world. That is also not perfectly. But there is spiritual world. Jadgatyana nivartante tadhyama paramam mama. Krishna says, there is another manifestation of his internal potency, that is eternal, blissful, and full of knowledge. Here, in this material world means it is not eternal, not blissful, and not full of knowledge. This is material. In the Vishnu Puran it is said, avidya karmasanga anya titya shaktirisha. This manifestation of energy is full of ignorance. The nature of this world is called darkness, tamasima, jyotirgama. So, sadasat rupaya chasu guna, gunamai aguna. Krishna, when he is called aguna or nirguna, that means he is not affected by these material modes of nature, above material nature. we are affected. We living entities, we are affected by the material modes of nature, satagun, rajagun, tamagun. But Krishna is not affected. That is Krishna, difference between Krishna and ourselves. In the Bhagavad Gita, there is another instance when Arjuna asked Krishna. Krishna said, Imam Vivasati Yogam Pratman Ahamabhyam. Krishna said that, first of all, I narrated this yoga system of Bhagavad Gita to the sun god. So, in order to clear this matter, Arjuna inquired from him, My dear Krishna, we are born very recently. How is that you narrated this yoga system to the sun god? Arjuna, of course, knew everything, but in order to clear our doubts, he raised this question. And Krishna answered that you were also present at that time, but you have forgotten, I have not forgotten. So this is another proof that Krishna's body does not change. Krishna, when he comes, when he appears, he comes in his original spiritual body. Therefore, Krishna has a word that abhijananti mang mura. The Mayavadi philosophers who think that Krishna has accepted a material body, they are described as mura. They have no sufficient knowledge. Parang bhava vajananta. They do not know what is the power behind Krishna. So, Krishna creates. Before creation, aham adihi devanam, in the Bhagavad Gita it is said. Devanam, first of all, Brahma was created, then other great sages were created, then other demigods were created. But Krishna says, aham adihi devanam. Therefore, he is not a created being of this material world. We have to consider in that way. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate vedanta sutta janmadasya jata. So Krishna is the origin of everything. Aham sarvasya prabhava iti matya bhajanti imam buddha bhava samanit. One who knows Krishna, the supreme adipurusam, adyam purana purusam, Navajauvananca. His knowledge is perfect. If one thinks Krishna as one of the product of this material world, then his knowledge is imperfect. He is still in the darkness of this material creation. So, those who are in the darkness of this material creation, they consider Krishna as one of the human beings, as a great scholar says, when Krishna says, manmana bhava mad bhakta mad jajimang namaskuru, the scholar points out that it is not to Krishna, it is up to the inner soul which is within Krishna. There is no within and without Krishna. Krishna, as we have got difference between within and without, Krishna has no such difference. And though one who does not know, they think, such person thinks Krishna as one of the product of material creation. That is not the fact. Svaividam sasajyagri bhagavan asamayaya sadasat rupaya chasu gunamai aguna bihu. Bibhu. He is Vibhu, we are Anu. That is the difference. Krishna is Vibhu, unlimited. We are limited. So we cannot be equal to Krishna. The Mayavad philosophy that there is no difference between Jiva and Bhagavan. There is sufficient defense. He is Vibhu. We are Anu. Anu Raniyang Mahato Maya. He is the greatest of the great. And he is the smallest also. Krishna cannot be equal, or nobody can be equal to Krishna or greater than Krishna. Krishna is asamartha. Nobody can be equal or greater than Krishna. Everyone is below Krishna. That is explained in the Chaitanya Chaitamrita. Ekola Ishara Krishna Arsa Vritta. Only Krishna is the Supreme Master. Ekola Ishara Krishna Arsa Vritta. Sivavrinchi Nutam. Even great demigods like Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, they also subordinate to Krishna. They offer their obeisances to Krishna. Sivabhinchi Nutam. And in the Brahma Sangita it is confirmed by Brahma. Ishara Parama Krishna. Ishara. Everyone can be called Ishara. Ishara means control. So, we are also controller of something. A businessman is controller of his business. I am controller of my disciples. There are so many controllers. So, in that sense, everyone is Ishvara, in the sense of controller. But Lord Brahma says, Ishvara Parama Krishna, the supreme controller. The supreme controller is Krishna. What is the difference between supreme controller and ordinary controller? Ordinary controller means that he controls and he is controlled, both. We are controller, but nobody can say that I am not controlled. We are controlled, but Krishna, he is controller but not controlled. That is the difference between Krishna and ourselves. So we cannot be equal with Krishna. We are controlled. I think in Glasgow, one boy, he was presenting himself as God. So I asked him whether you are controlled or not controlled. He admitted, yes, I am controlled. Then how you can be God? God is never controlled. God is controller, but he is not controlled. So if we take ourselves as so many samples of God, that is all right. But we are control God, not controller God. So that statement of Chaitanya Chaitamrita, Ekola Ishvara Krishna, Arsa Vritta, Jare Jaiche Nachaye Se Taiche Kare Nitya. We are controlled in every moment. So Krishna is Vibhu, we are Anu. Never consider that we are equal to Krishna. That is a great offense. That is called Maya. That is the last layer of Maya. Actually, we have come to this material world to become one with Krishna. We thought that we shall become like Krishna. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhogavan cha kare. Pasete maya tare japotiya dhare. Because we wanted to become one with Krishna, to compete with Krishna, therefore we are put into this material world. Maya tare japotiya dhare. And here in this material world, it is going on. Everyone is trying to become Krishna. That is Maya. Everyone. First of all, let me become a big man, then let me become the minister, let me become the president. In this way, when everything fails, then let me march into the existence of God, that may let me become God. This is going on. This is material struggle for existence. Everyone is trying to become Krishna. But our philosophy is different. We do not want to become Krishna. We are trying to become Krishna's servant. That is the difference between Mahabharata philosophy and Vaishnava philosophy. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaches us how to become the servant of the servant of the servant of the servant of Krishna. Gopi bhaktu padakamalayo daso daso dasanu daso. The one, a person who is the lowest of the servant of Krishna, he is first class Vaishnava. He is first class Vaishnava. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore teaches us Tinadapi Sunichena Tarorapi Sahishna Omanina Manadena Kitaniya Sadahari. This is the Vaishnava philosophy. We are trying to be servants. We don't identify with anything material. As soon as we identify with anything material, we become under the clutches of Maya. Krishna Bhulya, because as soon as I forget my relationship with Krishna, I am eternal servant of Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Jiver Sarupayal Nitya Krishna Das. That is the eternal identification of the living entity, to remain servant of Krishna. As soon as he forgets it, that is Maya. As soon as I think that I am Krishna, that is Maya. That Maya means this Maya illusion can be rejected by advancement of knowledge. That is Jnani. Jnani means this is real knowledge, to understand his real position. This is not knowledge, that I am equal to God, I am God. This is not knowledge. I am God, but I am sample of God. But the Supreme God is Krishna. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Arjuna accepted Krishna like that. Parabrahma Paramdhama Pavittam Paramam Bhava. Parabrahma. We may become Brahma. We are Brahma. There is no question of becoming. Aham Brahmasmi, this is not very difficult to understand. Because I am spirit soul, so I am Brahma. That's all right. But I am not Parabrahma. That is ignorance. I am not Parabrahma. If anyone thinks that he is Parabrahma, then it must be understood that he is under the clutches of Maya. That is the last snare of Maya. Therefore, Krishna says that when one actually becomes knowledgeable, cognizant, he surrenders. Bhavanam janvanam anti gyanaman mangs prabhadda. That is real knowledge. So, advancement of knowledge means to understand his real position and act accordingly. That is knowledge. That is perfection of knowledge. Simply to understand that I am Brahma is not perfection. You have to still go farther. Simply to understand that I am Brahma, I have now realized myself as Brahma, that is not perfection of knowledge. Brahma bhuta prasannatma. One who becomes realized soul, self-realized, he becomes immediately, perfectly joyful, because our all lamentation is due to our material identification. Sochati kankha. We are simply lamenting for our loss and we are simply hankering for some gain. This is material activities. Everyone is struggling to gain something which he does not possess and is lamenting for something which he has lost. But when he realizes himself that I have nothing to gain and nothing to lose, I have nothing to do with this material, that is called Brahma-bhuta. That is Brahma-realization. Brahma-bhuta prasannatma. Na sochati na kaan. Samas-sarvesu-bhutis. At that time he realizes that all living entities, they are spirit soul, pandita-samadarshina. That is equal vision. not the bodily vision. So long we have got bodily vision, there cannot be any equality. That is not possible. When one sees only to the spiritual existence of a living entity, then there is question of seeing equally, equal vision, universal brotherhood. That is possible. Not on the bodily platform. That is not possible. So, after acquiring this knowledge, the life of devotional service begins. Brahma bhuta prasanna atmana socha trina kankhati samas sarveshu bhuteshu mad bhakti lavate param. That is the work. And in that stage of devotional life, one can understand what is Krishna. Bhaktamam avijanati javan jaschami Krishna. Tattva. That is tattva to understand. In another place it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavad. Evam prasanna manaso bhagavata bhakti yogata. Unless one becomes jubilant, joyful, by executing devotional service, he cannot understand what is Krishna. It is not possible. So understand superficially Krishna, that he appeared in Mathura, in his uncle's prison house. That is also nice. But once you try to understand Krishna in fact, that fact can be revealed by devotional service. You cannot challenge Krishna. Krishna will reveal. Sevanmukhi jivhado samayva spuratva. If we become sevanmukh, if we try to serve Krishna as eternal servant of Krishna, then Krishna will reveal himself what he is. You cannot understand Krishna by speculation, by mental speculation. That is not possible. Atasya Krishna Namadi Navhavi Brahyam Indriyat. By sense perception you cannot understand Krishna. That is not possible. There are many versions of the saintly person. Just like Narottamdas Thakur said, Rupa Raghu Natha Pade Haibe Akuti Kabe hama bujhava se jugalapil. A saintly person, acharya, like Narottamdas Thakur, he says that when I shall be very much eager to understand the path of the six Goswamis, Eichhaya Gosai Jar Tarmui Das, we cannot understand Krishna unless we have submitted ourselves under the lotus feet of the six Goswamis, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We have to understand Krishna in this way. It is very difficult to understand Krishna. But by the grace of the Goswamis, by the grace of Lord Chaitanya, we can understand Krishna. Athapiti deva padam bujaddam prasada lesan grhita evahi janati tattam. Nachana ekopi chirang vichinna. Panthas, there are many sastic evidences. Panthas to koti satavastha sampragamma bayurathapi manaso munipangavana. So, by speculation we cannot understand Krishna. That is not possible. By mental speculation we cannot understand Krishna. We have to understand Krishna as Krishna says, or Krishna's devotee says, the Goswami says, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, then we can understand how this cosmic manifestation is created, who created, how it is created, everything will be clear. This is the beginning of such understanding. Saivedam sasajyagri bhagavan atamaya sadasat rupaya chasu gunamaya aguno vibhu. So, Krishna is transcendental, his position is always transcendental, even though he appears before us, still he is transcendental. This is understanding of Krishna. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.